The systems that we have been working with, especially the Mercator way of looking at maps, has been there for a purpose, and it was actually to really show the West in good manners. But if you look at how Africa is being depicted, when you put all the other things of the world on there, let me see, I can't get there. So the United States of America, Argentina, whole Western Europe, China and India, they all fit in Africa. It's a massive continent. When I fly from South Africa to Europe, I fly about 1.5 hours over Europe, and the rest of the time I fly over Africa. When I fly from Johannesburg to America, I fly 9 hours over Africa, still land to refuel, and then another 9 hours, and I'm in the States. Africa is really large. It's 20% of the world map, 1 billion people, 2,000 languages, 53 countries. But here, this is the Peters projection, which is the real land masses of the world. And what do we find? 2/3 of the world is in the south. Especially if you look at Europe or the Netherlands at this map, it is almost insignificant compared to the size of Africa, Latin America, even the United States, you know? And that's, we say, the center of the world. So this shows you how that looks like. It is that knowledge is not there, but Africa is really big. So the solutions that might be applicable in some of these areas, we already know that the one side of the United States and the other side of the United States is very different. Well, in this case, you see it's the other one side of Africa and the other side of Africa will be also very different. But Africa is being connected and is growing fast. There are sea cables lying around Africa. There were some talks that the capability of all the cables is enough what Africa needs in the coming time. So that's a good development. And the map on the bottom is the map of Facebook. It's the only continent where the traffic of Facebook is doubling every 7 months. So really something happened. There's a revolution going. Some people do it via the mobile phone and some through it through these cables. But what the problem is of these cables is nice that they are at the coastal towns, but very often that's where they stop. And there is a big inner land. From us to get to the coast is almost between 2,000 and 3,000 kilometers from where I live. To get to a nearby coastal village, let alone the cables, they are not there. They're getting there, but they are not there yet. So although Africa cities at the coast are being connected, the inner land is not. Internet is important, as we saw in the starting movie. What is internet? It's very important to understand what the internet is. And here I put a definition of myself. It's the definition of the internet as being all information, all the time, everywhere, everything and everyone is connected. That's my working definition of the internet, which is not a technical terminology. It's inclusive. It's this wonderful, vast world of interconnectedness. If we see the internet like that, then connectivity and the sea cables is just a part of it. The mobile phone is just part of it, if that's your way of access. Actually, access is just part of it. It's how we deal with it. It's the overall view of how we deal with the internet. And if this is true, then this shows you why we all need to be interconnected anyway. Because if this is what is coming up, we all need to be connected. We all need the tools to be connected. And there is no question anymore of why we would also want to interconnect in the rural areas of Africa. Do people need it? Well, if this is the definition, they must get it. So it's very important. It's an infrastructure like roads. There is little question that we need roads to be able to transport goods. But there is still some questions why we need internet in Africa. Well, that is actually a ridiculous question.